Hello friends, I'm so happy to be here again with you. So, when I have a lot of time, I like baking bread at home. So that's what I want to show you today. It's a recipe of simple bread making at home.
So for making the recipe, you will need 16 ounces of flour, a cup of water, a little bit of salt, sugar, yeast, and a little bit of olive oil. You will also need a bowl for mixing all the ingredients in, a cover for the bowl, and a spoon for stirring. Start by adding the lightly warm water in the bowl. Put a teaspoon of yeast in the warm water. Add a teaspoon of sugar. Stir it. Add 2 teaspoons of flour in the yeast mixture. Stir it again. Make sure you stir it very well. And then cover it until the yeast starts to make bubbles. It has to be covered and put in a warm place so the yeast starts to activate. And that's gonna take like 10 minutes. So as you can see, the yeast mixture is bubbling right now. So this is just the right time to start adding the flour. For the beginning, I will add 2 cups of flour and start stirring it very well. I'm gonna start putting in the salt. It depends how salty you want it to be. I just like my bread to be salty, and that's why I added more. But you can add just a little bit of salt if you don't want it to be very salty. So yeah, it looks like my dough is very liquid right now. That's why I want to add a little bit more flour. And that's again like 2 cups of flour. I'm gonna give it a nice stir again. It looks like I don't really need a lot more flour in my dough, but I'll just add a little bit more. Then this looks like the right time to start using your hands for kneading the dough. It is not hard, and you don't have to take a lot of time to do that. Just try to knead it a little bit until you can give it a nice shape. So my hands were feeling a little bit sticky, and I washed them as well as the bowl. I'm gonna use this bowl for letting the dough rest in and double in size. I'm adding the olive oil, and that's about 1 or 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And knead it just a little bit more, like 1 minute. And then cover it up and put it away for resting and double in size. My dough is ready now. I think that it doubled or tripled its size. Here I have two baking pans. I'm gonna start by splitting the dough in half. You get a little bit of oil on your hands, so it's gonna be easier and you're not gonna feel the dough very sticky. Split it in two. Get a half of the dough and put it in the first baking pan. If you're using a large one, you can leave the dough as it is and you don't need to split it in two. The first one is ready to go in the oven, and the second one is gonna be a flatbread. I grease the pan a little bit and then I'm gonna make the flatbread go in the pan. Use your hands to give it a nice shape. So this is what Italians call focaccia. It's a type of bread. Take the olive oil and put it out on the top, and again I'm gonna start pressing with my fingers the dough. It gives the dough a nice shape. So when it's baked, it looks very nice, and it's also very relaxing to do that, because I like my bread with herbs. I will add a little bit of herbs, and that's rosemary. It's dry rosemary. But you can also add the herbs that you want, and that's rosemary or basil, or maybe you want to put a little bit of cheese on the top. That's up to you. You can add also seeds like pumpkin seeds or sesame seeds. Again, that's up to you. I'm leaving it on the table for another 10 or 15 minutes so they can rest before they go to the oven. Meanwhile, I'm going to the oven and setting the temperature 350 degrees, and I will let it preheat until the dough is resting. So what I like to do is sifting the flour on the top of the bread and make a shape. It looks like they are ready to go to the oven right now. So one by one, the pans are going in the oven for baking. Make sure you don't get burned because the oven is very, very hot. I'm gonna set the timer for baking the breads, and that's gonna be 35 minutes. All it takes is waiting right now. So my bread just came out of the oven. I like the way it looks like. It looks very delicious. I like the shape on the bread as well. That's because I cut it before I put it in the oven. So now I'll just leave it on the table and cover it with a towel and let it cool, because you can't cut it when it's hot. It needs to be warm or cold. So it cooled down and I cut it. It's very fluffy and soft. I hope that you enjoyed the video and that you're gonna make it. Bon appetit now. Thank you for watching.